The judge prescribed 1 month to these persons to pay back monies they allegedly embezzled, as well as forfeit properties to the state. But His Excellency President Julius Maada Bio, in demonstration of magnanimity, gave a 3 month grace period. Remember, the judges gave a month, but His Excellency decided to give 3 months grace period, which elapsed on the 24th of December 2020. The consultant, the principal legal consultant in the Office of the Attorney General and Minister of Justice, Mr. Lahai Farmer, was here sometime last year to tell us about the preparedness of his office in working towards the implementation of the recommendations of the White Paper. As I mentioned, the 3 month period, the 90 days, this period has elapsed, and Mr. Farmer is here with us again this morning to furnish us with further information on the status of implementation of the White Paper. So at this point, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to invite Mr. Lahai Momo Farmer, Principal Legal Consultant in the Office of the Attorney General and Minister of Justice. Please come up and talk to the press. And after which we'll have questions from you.
Season's greetings to all of us. I do believe that we are still within our Christmas season and the New Year. Let me again extend my gratitude to the Ministry of Information and Communications for the active role they are playing, not only to disseminate information about my office, that is the Commission of Inquiry, implementing team, but we are also to understand that their role they play in society all over the world. To me, if you have to ask me to give an accolade and an award, I will give it to information communication technology in the world. It is for me on the 21st century has got the highest, development skills below medical sciences, because three of my brothers have died of cancer, prostate cancer, leukemia, malaria, no immunization, no cure, except by a lot of people have died of it. So thank you very much, Madam Minister, for your ministry. And again, I will recall, as she has just said, that I was here before the 24th of December, which she has just told you was what we have referred to as the grace period, which was given in our orders, particularly that regarding to reforms of money. I know all of you are interested more in that than the others, but I'm going backwards. Last I was here, I told you that we have three main stages in the implementation process. The first stage, I told you, was those dealing with orders which the government granted to confiscate or to revoke or for persons to lose, that we call it forfeiture of real assets, that is buildings with land, land without building, according to the investigations and recommendations that came from the reports of the three commissions of inquiry. That was the first stage that we engaged ourselves with as lawyers, a law firm to government. Next time here today, I will tell you, we have exhausted 20 of those orders, which we took them to court by the way of summonses. They have been heard, 15 rulings have been delivered. We are now putting those rulings in form of orders also, so that the master registrar will sign them. The next thing will be that we will come back to the Ministry of Information and obtain the permission that we go to the government printer to print them in gazette form. Mind you, I've seen a lot of my colleagues speak to me from the state asking me, let me have something on this, something on that. We are guided by law that every stage in the implementation or even in the commission's proceedings are guided by law. There are situations where you are forced to publish everything you do. So when the time comes, I will not renew. But before that time, it is not proper. For two reasons, I told one of my colleagues here who went to me from Exclusive, I said, you are an independent practitioner in the media. Our mouthpiece is the Ministry of Information with its agencies. If we go there, they give us permission, we print, you can collect it. But when that time comes, you'll not be interested. Because what normally you are interested in, first, to print. Whether correctly, that source is correct or not. But I don't believe in that. So let me again say that when that time comes to publish, we publish everything because there is going to be complete transparency about it. But for now, we are waiting for the orders to be printed, to be given to the government printers for 20 houses with lands scattered all over this country. When I can see their descriptions, I have them here, but I don't want you to go out. If you go look into the government white paper, they are all there, their addresses and the persons who are supposed to lose those properties. The second stage I told you was going to be, how are we going to recover money government has ordered to be refunded to the state out of unlawful acquisition or what we can call misappropriation by persons who were investigated and evidence came out to show that they have unlawfully acquired those monies in the form of fuel for themselves and for their personal use. Those reforms orders, we have about 136 persons whose those orders were granted against. And believe me, it is out of form, but it's not a funny thing. We tried to compute the figures. None of our computers will take it. Then I might say, what can we do? Let us go to the accountant general. He may have software for that. We wrote letter around the 16th of December for us to have these figures completed, because you cannot be going out for something you don't know the total number. As questions came from the public, how much are you going to spend on this commission? How much are you going to recover? So money is to be recovered. The total is yet to be given back to us. And when that time comes, I'll come back here to tell people that this is what we are supposed to recover, this is what we have recovered, and this is what is left over. As a way of telling you, in a very simple manner, this recovery of monies, the way we started it, government and its agencies, particularly FIU, let me pay homage to them again, the Financial Intelligence Unit, the Anti-Corruption Commissioners, were very, very active as they banned the withdrawal and transfer, what you call freezing of accounts belonging to these persons. That freezing has been on, and I believe it's one of our stages where this recovery. As I told you, I was encouraging people to go and pay before the 24th. It was not as somebody was saying, I was just saying, we can chase you, no. There's no way we can chase anybody to pay. We have legal ways by which we can recover those monies. Somebody is here, are you going to recover it violently or from your colleagues? And I said, no, we are going to do it with democratic sentiment, spiritual sentiment. But these are our brothers. What we want is not themselves, it's the money. Let them refund it. If they can pay today up to today, they will enjoy two privileges which His Excellency the President has granted them. The first is presidency is no. We are not going to ban anybody from holding public office. Yes. And the judges recommended again, let them pay this bond in 30 days. The president says, no, but 30 days too small. Well, let's not give you 90 days. Tell me too, for the layman to understand, if you take money from me, we'll go to court. Evidence is there to show that we have taken that money. And the court says, pay this money back. By common law, that day that order comes out, you are bound to pay that money. Don't you believe that? Yes, whether you like it or not. From the day they declare that money to be paid to that man, if the court cannot show that this money should be paid within 7 days, you are bound to pay on that date. But because they pay this man within 7 days, some of you go to the police station, you show your own time to pay. Is that also? They'll pay this money at the end of the month. If the police accepts it, then you are bound to pay that money and the creditor will not go to you until that period ends. So we are waiting graciously for them to refund these monies. You'll be entitled to the privileges not to be banned from holding public offices. And they'll be entitled to, certainly, what are consequences which I will tell you more come to the appeals. But what did they do? Instead of paying, we have about 85 appeals now that they have lodged against those orders. It is interesting. Because if you are appealing, you are saying that this order granted against me, I have very good reasons why I should not comply with it. But let us go to the court of appeal and explain it. If you believe you have good grants, nobody will force you to go free. But if your grants are not good, you go there. When you lose that matter, three things will go with you. The first, you'll be bound to pay that money instantly with interest. That's the second. Thirdly, I will also argue vehemently, that all the recommendations and whatever might have been given out in the orders be complied with. And probably I will even argue that the grace period, they decided to violate it. So then the convict and the sentence be equal. That is to say, if you pay this money, you'll be convicted, and that goes on record, which prevents you to hold in public office, who the president has said, no, I don't want my brothers not to be, tainted. So if Court of Appeal lose the matter there, I'm sure you will lose the privilege which the president has extended to you. So I'm encouraging my brothers to go and pay. If you cannot pay voluntarily, I'll not tell you the second stage where we are going. By law, you can keep money in the pocket for you. You get for paying me, you don't pay me. What do you tell you? Bank of Sierra Leone, all commercial banks are operating under the Bank of Sierra Leone. And these monies, as most of them are in the account, their accounts. The law says that if you have to pay government out of the commissions of inquiry order, if you refuse to pay, we have to write officially for all those monies in those accounts to be turned over into the specific account belonging to government. And this time we have established a recovery account. It's a single letter, so sometimes just 3 paragraphs. So that all those who have monies in their accounts will turn over. And I believe when that is happening, most of us, we never did accounting. So we invite experts who are accountants from our government accounting firm, that is the Ministry of Finance, Bank of Sierra Leone. They can call people to supervise the recovery of those monies from those accounts. And when that happens, all the privileges you have, whether you are appealing or not, you take that money. When you are appealing, the recovery fund system can give you back. If you cannot win, we have to again surcharge you. I don't know whether it will be a commercial interest that you have to levy on it, plus the principal sum to be paid, and cost of the appeal. Those who have opened their eyes to the court system, you know how expensive appeals are. You know, even the records they have given to me, one person's record, the height is like this, 3 copies, like this. You may not know. I'm not sleeping, but I believe that I'm serving my people. I don't want us to get the wrong perception of them. That is why I want you, please, those who are brothers, let us try and encourage them. Let them go and pay. Go can't pay. I had one of my elderly statesmen say, if you know you took it, who won't pay? Yes. It is better for you to die, you know, with gracious death than for you to be dragged to your grave. I'm not hoping that anybody is going to be dragged. We have some very democratic means of collecting those. When we take it from your account, if it is insufficient and one of your houses has not been mentioned to be taken, we fall on that house again by law. We'll take it and sell it to those who want to buy. If that money cannot be paid again in full satisfaction, we'll go on to enter into your room and take your bed and sell. So we'll continue to do that until we find out that if even we have sales, all your bed, everything, the money is still hanging over there. We'll be watching you every time you buy something that is of value to you. That is where my colleague's question comes and will chase you and take it from you. So, as a matter of encouragement, because hearing is too small. You people are saying we are 7 point something million. But tell me, how many of us are really in cities? We meet every day. Either you are my friend or you are my cousin or my brother. I would not like the Lord to chase you. But I don't have any way to stop it. Even His Excellency the President cannot stop it. It is people's permission. He can only stop it when you people petition Him. So do your part. This thing, the Lord Jesus Christ, that's all we need. My left and another again, I want bicycle wagons. But let us not drink that stage. If I were there, I would have just come to say, I have 60% of this money. I cannot pay this money all together, or otherwise I would die. So please accept the 60%. Let us go into arrangement to be paid. Then government can make another arrangement for you. You'll be paid probably until your grandchildren come and continue to pay. Once you know you are paying our money, we don't want to use the kind of force that will embarrass you in the economy and regard government as a bad government. Because we are still employed. Go and pay. Some of them have this money in graves. They have pretended that their cousins have died. They have taken those monies, planted them into coffins, taken them into. That's why a few months before election, graves have been opened in this country, including my wife's grave. Those guys are looking out for glacial monies are. And safety is continuing. No wonder why there was no cash in the economy before Christmas. So please, those who are brothers, let us encourage them to pay. That is the manner in which we have to make sure we recover all of those monies that have been, you know, ordered to be paid. We can use the last weapon in law. Then third stage, I've discussed with you, one, the orders of confiscation which we have obtained. Number two, we are now on recovery of our funds after the 24th of December. Those accounts are banned. They have not been using it. If ever it is discovered that you have been using it, you should be doing it at your own disadvantage. If you go take and put an agreement, you can say, we'll bring a car. We don't bring it. We'll take everything that is there, and if you cannot satisfy our debts, we'll chase as the other gentleman said, other assets, not you. Other assets. So, for me to encourage you, that is all. The appeals are on. We have started replying to them. We have received orders from the court. So, I'm pretty sure that by the end of the week, all those orders will be around for publication. We'll start towards the end of the month to reply to those appeals. May God bless us all. Thank you very much for this.
Thank you very much, Mr. Farmer. Ladies and gentlemen of the committee, can I invite questions? So if you're sitting in front of the microphone and you want to ask a question, once you're called upon, just press the mic and then you can go ahead. Otherwise, you wait for the microphone to get to you and then you can go ahead and ask a question. Indicate your name and the media outfit you represent. Thank you.
go ahead, sir. Yes, one question per person, because we want to have as many people as
possible. Okay, okay. Thank you. I'm Dauda Koroma, editor of It's Opposed to Sleep. Yes, sir, Mr. Foreman. This 15 ruling that the court has given, whenever the ruling has been given, it's not a hidden secret. So please, sir, I want to know the 15 people that the court have given the ruling, please. So that is not an issue to be hired. Yes. Get the people, sir, the name of the people.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Standard Times, yes, Kone. Give it to the man at the back, yes.
Mohammed Kone is the name, and I write for Standard Times newspaper. Mr. Farmer, is this just a way to tell the people that have not paid for them to pay? Because from what I'm hearing from is that people have refused to pay. Have they refused to pay? That is what you are telling us.
Okay, thank you. Yes.
I'm sorry, Cecil.
I write for Congress.
So,
please
stop that mic.
Turn it
off. Turn it off, yes, thank you. Yes, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, I write for Congress. Mr. Farmer, we've seen cases wherein houses have been confiscated and later returned to the owners. What difference with this particular movement?
Okay, thank you very much. More, any more? Aouna, yes, SMBC.
Aouna Patrick-Kumar from SMBC. Mr. Farmer, we just want a clear picture as to what's next. We really want that to be clear. What next? As the deadline for the next period, as you said, already.
Thank you. We'll take one more and then allow Mr. Farmer to respond. Yes, up to you here. Let's take a lady.
Even the rulings that have been delivered, we need to perfect them. That is, we have to go with the ruling and make the orders that were granted, give it to Master Registrar. When it's stamped, then it will come as a public document. And that's what we are going to publish. Just give us some time. It's going into the government gazette. If you want it to be when it is being sent to file, because as of now, the casino, the judge did not say this. He said this. Therefore, it costs to give you the names of the persons and properties.
You see, if you go out to check for individual names at this time, the properties to be missing, let us have things, let us publish all of them, the houses, the addresses, to serve each and every good institution. Then the second question is of Standard Times. He said, is this the way?
He said, is this the way
to pay? Because they can refuse. Well, yes, it is.
For many good reasons.
Sometimes when somebody has to pay you and you don't want to pay you, that word you use last time. Violence.
Violence.
It's a democracy now. And our democracy is a democracy. We tell you to go and pay. It's our education. It's the issue. The father in this house. Yes. Your wife reminds you.
Your wife reminds you to give it.
There are those who are different. There are those who are monies. Those who are the real stars, who are those real stars. But there are some hospitals that have to chase them to be. It's about that we chase the amount of that we can ignore it. I'm not ashamed of telling you that the grace period has expired. All the benefits associated with the grace period is not almost reformed. When we are not taking from you, we are not taking from your asset rights. And if you say you're going to depend upon your ability, when you produce such a bill, you're going to take the most money we will get back. But when we go full fledged with that bill, I don't want to open the election here. But before 1991, the law that existed, did not allow anybody to on President's order. That's Star 54. Those who are Act 54, one of the laws of 1960. You know very well that it was the governor general who was representing the by Act number 1, that is the Commission of the Quality of the Nation Act, 1982, that tells you that that section, subsection 5 of section 7, says once the president overturns any law, nothing will stop it to be implemented. When 1991 Constitution came out, they set up a paragraph known as paragraph 9, that these commissions are required. That paragraph 9 starts with 147, you have to set it up. How can it go on? Then what comes out of the report, of the commissioner? The commissioner should prepare the report, their findings and their report and their recommendations. Government should take those reports and recommendations. Such a period should come up with orders. Now, but that one under subsection 4 or section 149 says that the orders can be appealed. Now, to answer your question properly, by then the next government came into power, they looked at those whose properties are confiscated in 1967. No. And say these guys, no abuse they are available. So, what do we do? We advise His Excellency and the only way to return these properties is to set up at those abuses. That we act as an appellate for to review those confiscations. That's why today we are proud to have this. That is why we have so many other buildings, particularly the one that I was in, the Pandas View at Aberdeen. I was in one of the buildings, and I was acting at that moment as legal secretary. The committee that was set up. And my house was returned to the bankers.
Yes.
I did not suffer because they told me that if you are here, you have to hear it. Decided to hear it. And government came into rescue also believe it was serious about to relocate us. So that period before 1991, appeals were not granted against orders of the president. When the democracy came, they said, no, Mr. Ward, don't try it. Appease our people. They were not appealing. Let us make them appeal against orders of the president. You know, the president is always being advised by cabinet. He's a big guy. So, that time when they advised him and he says something, nothing, no law is being picked up. But now, it's appealing. So, if you lose your appeal, I will never return that property to you. In fact, there will be every instance to show that there are people who want to buy it, they will sell it to them. So when I thought party rights is not vested, I don't think there will be any. What next? That is what I have told you, the processes. how we are going to recover these monies, how are we going to get these properties to the value of the state and recover and for us to have them. When our package shall drive them away from there, and we will reject them. So, then the last one, the appeals started. As I have told you, a single man's appeal records is like this. If the registry have to do records of nearly 85 of that, and please they have delivered about 8. Probably all argue those 8, some people decide to go and abandon the appeal and come back to say, please let me pay this money. He said to me, His Excellency is always gracious. If you come with all of our money, what next? How will you know? Not your life, not your property, but money. So I think, Satil, he said whether this money will be fully paid or we want. Yes, we are not very much care about the money to be paid because His Excellency said very clearly and His Cabinet that we are not going to ban them. That is the punishment, to ban somebody from holding public office. But President says no, let them just pay the money. I don't know if you're concerned with that. But if you cannot pay within that grace period, as I've said, then you go to court of appeal. When you lose that matter in court of appeal, I will advocate very strongly, not only for you to pay our principal money, to pay interest, plus the bank should be installed upon you, because you violated your privilege. And it's not only me, all of the team.
All right, thank you very much, Mr. Kamau. Take the second set and probably the last set of questions. So we'll start from the students on the back. Mani, are you ID? And yes, come next.
Where is it? Black. Yes,
hello. Sam Pratt, Open Space, Mr.
Go ahead, sir.
It is my understanding, Mr. Foreman, it's my understanding that 136 people, their accounts were frozen and are still frozen. Should in case a member or some of them want to pay or refund or want to settle part of their what they've stolen or alleged to have stolen, how are they going to go about it when their accounts are still frozen?
Thank you, sir. Yes,
Mamiya? Mohamed Lamin, Banya from AYE. Mr. Afama, I was expecting you to inform us if one or two people have complied in refunding their money. The other one is, I want to know if further penalties is to be given for people that are delaying.
For the money, I write for the Calabash newspaper. Mr. Farmer, in your submission, you said Section 54 gives the power for appeal. And in this case, you already have about 85 appeal. So are you going to take action now, or you're going to wait for the outcome of those appeal? Because when somebody appeal, it means they are not satisfied with what has been said against them. So are you going to wait for the appeal, or you're going to take action and you wait now after the outcome of the appeal?
I already did call, I write for the exclusive newspaper.
Mm-hmm.
I already did call, I write for the exclusive newspaper. Yeah. Mr. Farmer, we are expecting you to update us about the payment of the reported payment of Honorable Alpha Khan, the former Minister of Information. We never did that. And why is it that his own payment was made public and then the others have been kept secret?
Thank you. One more. Any more?
May I start from the funding pool about Alpha Khan? You know,
The law respects individual privacy. If everybody owes debts, when you pay, you have to go to public. Or the creditor has to carry you to public and explain to the public that you have paid. I think it's not fair. I think I choose to go public. There are those who are paying who are saying, in fact, some, I don't even see them. Not even the attorney general. Sometimes they pay, they post the bank slip. But I'm saying that when the bank slip of payment comes in, go and find it. We are still to verify whether those payments are affected. So if I come out now to say that 10 people have paid, I'm not going to check the, how do you call it, the recovery account, input and output, or whatever may be in there, then I'll be lying to you. And graciously speaking, I don't like to lie, but to say we have half-truth. Half-truth is always a lie. If you can help me, you can go to Accountant General. He has ultimate respect for people who can give you how to pay when the accounts are frozen. This is a very brilliant question. If you want to pay, come to us and apply that you want to pay. So many amounts of money from an account into this report reforms. We can grant you to go and remove the bank to remove and transfer that money to the treasury into some revolving fund. It does not cost us to lift open the gate. We want to pass only one foul, then all of them escape. Is that sensible? You said 85 appeals. Are we going to wait? Before that implement, an appeal, go to your friend lawyers. An appeal is not a stay of execution of judgment. If I have a judgment, you have not obtained any stay, I have to implement it. If it turns out that you are asking for a stay, you should show special circumstance. If you are a chief man, you say, stay, they said I paid this money. But please, Mr. Court, allow me land of day. What circumstance do you show, will you show that it's very special, that it should not be? That's what the stealth is showing we're asking for. But away from the general law, let us come to this, the law of the condition of the fire. They are saying it's appealable as of right. But it's not a stay. When you appeal, who are we to be appeal? Who are we to take our money? There will be no special circumstance lying. We are taking this money to be put in the public. When you win, you come and pay. If you lose, we pay our principal money plus interest, then we give, we advocate to you for bank.
Thank you very much.
I did that stuff.
Yes. Gentlemen and ladies, good afternoon. Let me use this opportunity to reiterate all of the goodwill messages you have had for the new year. To also wish you a happy and very prosperous new year, which will hopefully remember as the golden year of Sierra Leone's beginning, celebrating this year's anniversary. So yes, Mr. Farmer has been very, very, very much on point. I just needed to re-echo this sentiment around the publication of names. Our government, His Excellency President Julius Maada Bio's government, has brought in a new tradition of transparency and accountability. He has said in several speeches that we will not settle for less or greater scrutiny. We started the commission on a very open note. For the very first time in the history of our country, the commissions were held in open court with the media doing live coverages and all of it. Nobody was intimidated, nobody was coerced as the naysayer had predicted. Everything went on seamlessly. So in the same way, we will be publishing the names of all of those who have complied with orders once we get a comprehensive list from the Accountant General's office. We think this is public interest and we deserve to fulfill that bit of it. Again, just in case the Yeah, is there any reluctance? The right to access information commission, which this ministry also houses, can be a result. But we will not get there to ensure that. Once we get a comprehensive list, we will publish it. In much the same way as the government gazette will be publishing names of people who by law have forfeited property of our own, whose properties have been confiscated. Right? So we'll go for more scrutiny, not less. And this is public interest, and we'll ensure that we'll give that to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Minister. Ladies and gentlemen, I think
so what I said, if there's going to be a further penalties for those that are delaying, and also how many people have complied so far?
Sorry, I will not agree as I say further penalties. There are penalties to the government has said, no, we are not going to accept it. That it should be back. Before the penalties that you will be referring to will be if you go to appeal and loses the appeal, if you have not paid, leaving me or not, we are going to only ask for our principal money, we'll be asking for interest and cost of the case. Then lastly, after we impose the ban, because to complete the conviction, there must be a sentence of penalty. So let me not forget again. Let me congratulate the people on the Millennium Township, in which the drive towards corruption has been rated very high. And I believe the Anti-Corruption Commission, this Commission of Inquiry, together with what is happening in society for those people who are against the money, government has spoken and set up. We are going to talk.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
One last question.
We have to get to the outside. Thank you very much. So hopefully